A charter school resource officer is under investigation in Florida today after arresting two children ages 6 and 8.
When 6-year-old Kaya Roll was arrested Thursday at Lucius and Emma Nixon Academy in Orlando, her grandmother, Marilyn Kirkland, couldn't believe the call. Kirkland says even after she explained that Kaya's outburst was likely the result of a medical condition, the 6-year-old was still charged with battery.
The headline reads, a 6-year-old child threw a tantrum at school before being arrested and charged with battery. Okay, are people aware this doesn't happen in other developed countries, especially not the, quote, freest country in the world?
She says her granddaughter was even taken to a juvenile center for fingerprints and a mugshot.
No 6-year-old child should be able to tell somebody that they had handcuffs on them.
An investigation is underway after an Orlando school resource officer arrested two elementary school children, ages 6 and 8, on misdemeanor charges. He failed to follow department policy that requires officers to firstly obtain approval from a watch commander before arresting minors. One of those was a 6-year-old girl who, according to reports, threw a tantrum in class, like many of us did at 6 years old. Hers was because, according to her grandmother, she suffers from sleep apnea and it prevented her from getting enough rest the night before. Her grandmother noted that the episode resulted in a trip to the office where a school staffer tried to grab her wrists to calm her down, prompting the girl to kick back. This then resulted in the child's arrest, and she was sent to a juvenile detention center to provide fingerprints and also a mugshot. Now listen, the catch-22 of having an officer be on hand in American schools is this. While the country refuses to bring forth any common sense gun control measures, armed officers are unfortunately needed. But what this also comes with is a responsibility to ensure kids are not being criminalized for misbehavior that has traditionally been handled by teachers or school administrators, something that criminal justice advocates have raised concerns over in the past, especially with countless studies showing that the criminalization of children disproportionately impacts students of color and students with disabilities. A report from the Education Department's Office for Civil Rights found that between 2015 and 2016, black students represented 15% of the total student enrollment during that year, but made up 31% of the students referred to law enforcement or subjected to school-related arrests. Now, similarly, students with disabilities made up 12% of overall enrollment and 28% of those referred or arrested. And this is why I, on prior videos, and many activists have consistently called attention to the lack of school counselors in American schools. According to a study carried out by the 74, school security officers outnumber counselors in 4 of the 10 largest public school districts in the country. Not to mention that none, and I repeat, none of the top 10 districts where counselors may be particularly beneficial, especially for low-income students, meets the American School Counselor Association's recommendation of one counselor for every 250 students. Most weren't even close. Now, of course, the security and safety of the children is a priority. But when you see 6-year-olds being criminalized for something we've all been guilty of as kids, more attention is desperately needed on how we're going about rectifying this issue.
Want to see more videos like this? Then subscribe to the TYT channel below. And don't forget to become a TYT member. Get access for as little as $4.99 a month. Download the TYT Plus app on your phone or head over to tyt.com/join today.